Okay, so getting into and getting out of the fiddle solo is kind of tricky because a lot of instruments are in the mix right there, and it's hard to really pick out that violin part. So I'm just kind of gravitating to a couple notes and getting into it that way. So what I'm hearing is like this. I hear that 1, 2, 3 of a major chord. And then do, ti, do. So do, re, mi, re, do, ti, do. So if we use that as our jumping in point, and I don't really think that's what the violin's doing, but that's kind of what I'm hearing right there with other instruments. So that's kind of what's sticking out to me anyway. That's what I mean, so. So right there, I'm just thinking in D major. 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, major 7, back to the 1. And from here, he goes up this D Lydian scale and sets up this A major. So root, major 7, root. He plays the lower neighbor to the tonic. And then he slides into the major 3rd, so you got. So after he gets this major 3rd, he goes. So you see it does that 16th note triplet in there. It's like. Let's do that one again, so. I went down to this G sharp, and then I roll my pointer and land on this F sharp. So all together you've got. Let's do that line again. Right there, he just goes. He's just coming down the A major scale. You could think of it as A major or whatever. And landing on the perfect fourth, that D note. And then he does again the lower neighbor to kind of boost himself back up with the goal of arriving at this C sharp again. So from here. Then I'm kind of taking some liberty on the guitar to do some bends and stuff. And that's kind of what I'm doing there. So. Okay, one more time. So we're sliding into C sharp twice, and then he has this slow slide into the C sharp. So I'm just doing a bend right there. So we've got this. Let's do that again. So we do this hammer on and then slide to this A and hit it twice. So we got this. Let's do it again. Okay, and then we've got this little, again, translating from violin to guitar, taking some artistic liberty. So we got this bend here. Again, I'm not really sure if that's how the violin is getting out of the solo, because there's, again, the blend of the other instruments makes it hard for my tone deaf ears to hear anything, so. So I think he's doing is this little bluesy thing. It's kind of a pentatonic, bending 17 of the B string. And then hitting this F sharp, bending like kind of a unison bend. We're in D major, the last chord is a D major, so we're bending the second into the major third. Hitting the perfect fifth, back down to third, the nine to the tonic, so. The major seven, major sixth, perfect fifth, the arpeggio from here. 5-3-1, but I think he hits the 3 twice. And then he bends this B into C sharp, I think. And then the singing comes back in. So altogether that last line is. Let's do that one again.